They came with their clothing in a trash bag, you know, ill-fitting pajamas, dirty clothing, things that just didn't fit, and you know, shoes that didn't fit. So we saw the need immediately.
Helping out foster children in need, whether it's Christmas time or summertime, one organization is making sure no child is forgotten. News 5's Valerie Abatey takes a look at For Jamie's Sake.
This small room here in Northern Kentucky is helping out in a big way. It's providing gifts not only for Christmas, but year-round for foster kids.
We were incredibly grateful for whatever assistance we got from our friends, and now we're able to provide that same assistance.
When Ben Wilson and his wife first became foster parents, they saw how kids, being placed with families, had only a trash bag of dirty clothes for their possessions.
So we saw the need immediately on our first placement, and it really touched our heart and really felt that we could help other kids so that they don't have to come into care in that fashion.
They heard about an organization in Ashland, Kentucky, called For Jamie's Sake, named after a foster child named Jamie. So they started a branch in Northern Kentucky, which provides clothing, shoes, and even Christmas gifts for kids in the foster care system.
So we're providing Christmas gifts for the children that are in group homes. Today we have a big pickup for the Brighton Center.
It's just one of 20 organizations benefiting from For Jamie's Sake, where on this trip, the Brighton Center received teen and baby clothes for specific families.
It fills the gap. There's no other organization in Northern Kentucky that's helping us with these children in the foster care system.
And for Ben and his family, it's a way to fill a need, as well as spread some holiday cheer.
Well, it means they get Christmas.
Some of the biggest requests that the organization get are for items like suitcases, even socks and underwear. And if you'd like to help, you can find some of their bigger requested items on Facebook. Valerie Abatey, News 5.